Hey guys, it's me, Panto6, and I have a surprise for you guys a little bit early, but I figured I'd share it with you. Today I tweeted out to Rod Ferguson. If you guys all know him, he is the pretty much the guy that runs the show over at Coalition, which is the new studio that's working on the Gears of War series for Microsoft. I tweeted out to him and I asked him about a code so I can show you guys early. And he sent me a code. It's pretty awesome because I guess the beta doesn't really come out until I think it's 2 days from now, maybe on the 18th. I'm not really sure. But he did send it out to me. All I had to do was show off my Gears of War tattoo, and he let me in. And so, Ron, if you're watching this, thank you so much for sending out the code. And guys, be sure to follow him on Twitter at gearsviking.com. Hell of a guy. Awesome dude. Anyways, so I've been playing a little bit of the Gears of War 4 beta, multiplayer beta, and it feels like Gears of War. I mean, if you played any other Gears of War game, you know exactly what you're getting into. Gnasher shotguns and smoke grenades. But it plays really, really well. I really like it. It feels really polished for something that's in beta. If you play the Ultimate edition of Gears of War that came out last year, the visuals are about the same. Now, this is supposed to be running on Unreal Engine 4. The multiplayer aspect is 60 frames per second, 1080p, I think, and the single player is 1080p, 30 frames per second. That's kind of where most game devs are going for these days. If you're doing multiplayer, it's usually best to do 60 frames per second. Which I don't mind. See, I as long as the game is playable and the frame rate does not completely suck, and I probably lose my marks as a PC gamer for saying this, but I don't care if it's 60 frames per second or not. But if I'm on my PC, I do care. But the game does play really, really well. As a Gears of War fan, I have played every single Gears game, 1, 2, 3, Judgment, all the DLC, as well as the Ultimate Edition of the remastered first game that came out last year. And me and my friends, we always really, really liked this game. I remember when Horde Mode came out for, I think it was Gears of War 2, we spent, I think it was a couple days after launch, we spent almost 6 hours trying to get to Wave 100. We finally finished that. It was either Wave 100 or I forget what it was. But we just had a blast. It took us, I think it took 6 hours. I'm not sure. It's been a long time since we did that. But as far as like games that I love, and it might make me sound like I'm a Xbox fanboy for saying this. Halo, Gears of War, Metal Gear Solid, Resident Evil, Final Fantasy, a few other games. I love these games. I love Gears of War, and the story is so and so. I mean, I like it. I think it's a great game series. It's something you don't have to super think about. The characters are relatable, sort of, and it does have this moments, and I dare say you cannot tell me you played Gears of War 3, and this is a spoiler alert, but it's been so long since this game came out. Whenever Dom sacrificed himself to kill a bunch of Lambda, whatever they are, Locust, it choked me up. It choked a lot of my friends up. It was like, oh my God, not Dom! Not Dom. Why did he have to die? But it was good. It's bittersweet. I even like Judgment. Judgment was a good game. It was a side game. It's nothing. It is canon. It takes place before Marcus Fenix gets out of jail. And but at the end of the game, it does have something that ties into the third game in the series. So if you like Baird and Cole, I check out Judgment. It's worth playing. It's cheap. If the game itself, I mean, it's probably the best playing of the Gears games, as far as just how it plays and how it looks. It probably is the best looking and best gameplay. for the series, but, you know. Anyways, so if you guys are wondering how this demo is, well, it's demo, beta, it's just really, really great. There's this gun. I don't remember it ever being in the other games, but then again, I could be wrong, because I played a little bit in the multiplayer, just for a little bit. I was in the multiplayer beta whenever the Ultimate Edition had its beta for the first game. I think this gun's called a drop shot, and I hate this gun. I fucking hate it, because, say if you take cover, all I have to do is shoot above you, and this thing comes down like a hammer and just smashes the shit out of you. So cover with this gun is not good. And they used to have another gun, I think it was on Gears of War 3, it shot it's like a grenade that went under the ground and exploded. It's very similar to that. My favorite thing to do, if you haven't noticed, in the background I got some gameplay. I lose a lot. I'm terrible. I am terrible at multiplayer games. I don't know why. There's some I'm good at, some I'm not. But my favorite thing to do is most likely go in, throw in some gas grenades, and just chainsaw the shit out of everybody. That's one of my favorite things to do. And I got a few of those kills. Got a few of them. But I put in probably so far about 2 hours into the beta. I just got it about 2.5 hours ago. Went ahead, downloaded it, and started playing it. There's about 3 maps you can play. You can play as the Locust. I think they're Locust. I'm not sure. They look like the Locust. I'm not really sure what the enemy is on the fourth game. I don't think they completely came out and said what they were. I'm pretty sure they are the Locust. I don't know if they're like the Lambda. I think it's Lambda. I could be completely wrong. That's Half-Life. But anyways, I don't know what version of the Locust this is. Now, I know the game itself takes place 20 years after the events of number 3, and you play as Marcus Fenix's son. If you guys haven't seen the trailer that was released, it was like about a week ago, I believe. I made a video on that. It was that with the Titanfall video, and it's pretty good. They use Disturbed's version of Sound of Silence, and, you know, it makes a trailer. But if you guys are wondering how this is going to turn out, or if you are skeptical about the studio screwing this up, I don't see any worries. I don't see any worries at all. It runs fine. Rod Ferguson and the Coalition are going to do great. Rod Ferguson was there since the beginning of the Gears franchise, so he knows what people want and what people don't want, and I'm hoping he hits the ball out of the park. I mean, if you want to compare him like to Microsoft's other first-party studios, 343 took over Bungie for Halo, and I think they did a fantastic job. There's a lot of people who debates that. I know the Master Chief Collection was left a lot of like a bad taste in a lot of people's mouth, but I really enjoyed it. Except for the multiplayer, but now it seems to be working fine. But Halo 5 was fine. The story was eh, but it was fine. It's probably leading up to bigger things to come. But the Coalition has this. Rod, Gears Viking, they're going to do a great, great, great job. And in terms of community for the Gears, Gears of War as a whole, as fans, I can't think of any nicer gamers. A lot of them are really awesome. Myself, you know, I got a Gears of War tattoo right on my arm. It's the Crimson Head. I think not Crimson Head. It's the Crimson Skull, I believe that's what it's called. Or Gear Skull. But there's a lot of people who uses the logo, and they're just nice people. They have a whole Gears army. So if you guys want to check it out, I believe the beta opens up on the 18th to everybody. It's either the 18th or the 24th, I forget. But be sure to check it out. Play the game. It's awesome. It's fun. It runs really smooth. And hopefully you guys enjoy it. I'm so sorry about the stuttering. I'm still working on that. But another thing I want to talk about. One more thing before I let you guys go. I am working on a project that helps. It's going to help me And it's going to help a lot of people in my area or people in the surrounding areas that want to be a part of it. And that is called Bits and Pieces. What it is a game store, but sells things like comic books, video games, card games like Magic the Gathering, Pokemon, Force of Will, Yu-Gi-Oh, you name it. But it's not the only thing we're doing. Hopefully, once, if we can get this thing rolling, we'll be opening a little bit of a place where you can get lunch, like deli meat, stuff like that, like a deli sandwich. And also, we'd have tournaments, special guests, giveaways, game nights, lock-ins. But the cool thing about this project is something that I really, really wanted to do. As you guys know, I have suffered with clinical depression for a while. You guys also may know as well that I've tried to commit suicide. This was a long time ago. You can look back on my Let's Talks and you can see the video where I talk about that. What I want to do is be able to have a place for people, young people, or people my age that's had problems with depression. You know, if somebody's been abused, being bullied, or anything like that, or just not having a great time at home, something's, you know, really hurting them. This would help these people out, as well as we'll be able to hold events where we can come up with some money to help young kids for, you know, backpacks, lunch for school, t-shirts, clothing, toys. That's something what I want to do. I want to help out people that suffers with these problems. Anxiety, depression, suicide, it's not a joke. I mean, you know, there's a lot of people that has these problems. And I've had few people in my life that's committed suicide. I've been down this road. I know what it looks like. And it's really, really hard to explain. But, guys, if you wouldn't care, check out my GoFundMe account. It's at www.gofundme.com/bitsandpieces. Now, I'm not saying you have to donate. You don't have to at all. But if you wouldn't care, please go ahead and share this. The more people that share this, the better it can be. I just need to get help getting the notice. If it can take off, then I expect it to be something really, really special. But guys, thank you so much for checking out this video. I'm going to let you guys watch the rest of this gameplay. Be in mind, I do die a lot. I die a lot. So if you're looking for somebody that's, you know, MLG, nah, it's not happening here. But I got some really good kills. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for checking this out. I love you. And also, be sure to like and subscribe. Every single time somebody subscribes, that's awesome for me and it's awesome for you. And I can continue to make these videos. So I love you guys. And here in a couple weeks, I got an announcement to make. And it might be pretty cool. Something I'm going to try to do personally, but I'll let you guys in a couple weeks as I kind of figure it out myself. But again, like I said, love you guys and thank you so much for stopping by.
Down in front!
I see you!
Thank you. He's gonna leave these lying around?